Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am back with another tag video, and just before I start, I am doing this with my child in the room. It's the only chance I can get to do it, the life of a working mum. I hope that we don't get too much interference. I will hear it when I play it back to edit. If it's too much, I'll try and do it again. If there's a little bit of noise in the background and you hear some toys, I'm sorry, but that's what it is. Just he is here, and hopefully this works okay. So this tag video that I am back with is the handbag deal breakers tag. I was tagged in this by both Mary from Snow7707 and also stylebygwenny, and it is for the things that rule you out of handbags, things that handbags have that I can hear the giggles, and things that handbags have that would just make you not buy them, just completely deal breakers for you, rule them out. So I'm going to go through those and hopefully this works okay. Before I jump in, if you're new, if you haven't yet, if you like luxury content, reviews, unboxings, that sort of thing, please do hit the subscribe button and ring the bell to be notified when I upload. And also, if you could give this a thumbs up if you enjoy it, it would be so much appreciated. And I will link down below in the comment box, I will link both Snow7707 channel and also stylebygwenny, and please do check out their videos. The first deal breaker for me, and I have here just the mini pochette, which I appreciate isn't really a bag, but just to show what I mean, is that it has to fit my phone. If a bag is going to be, I like to be hands-free, I like to carry them cross-body, and if a bag doesn't fit my phone in it, that would rule it out for me. I really like the round Chanel clutch on chain, I think it's called. They come in some fab colours. I think they're so pretty, but they don't fit a phone. And if it doesn't fit a phone for me as a handbag, that just rules it out and would make it a bit unworkable for me. The next thing that would be a deal breaker and rule me out is price. Now, I don't have an actual limit or an actual number that I would say if a bag is this price or goes beyond it that I won't buy it. It's more if I feel that the bag for what it is doesn't justify the price. And the example that I'm going to use is this little beauty. Now, this is the Chanel 17B rose gold that is so sought after. It's a complete unicorn. You can see it shimmering in the colors of the light. It is stunning, it's beautiful. I have it in the mini version, and I absolutely love this bag, but the price that they have gone for now on the resale market. And another example of this would be the Pearl Mini that is also so sought after and stunning. There was one recently for sale, and I would love the Pearl Mini just even to have. I know you have to be careful using it, but I would just love to have it. But the one on Instagram very recently was for selling for over $9,000. Now, that to me is just too much. That price just is a deal breaker for me. That rules me out. In saying that, I've never bought any bag for $9,000. I don't have any Hermes bags, because at the minute the price of an Hermes bag would also rule me out. I really like the Kelly 25. I think some of the colours are stunning. I don't know if that will ever be attainable for me or for in my budget. So the price of Hermes rules me out, definitely. The price of that Pearl Mini on the resale market ruled me out. And the price that this is at now would probably rule me out as well, because I think these are up around $8,000. I can hear the music from his toys. I don't know what it's going to be like on the video, but we'll see. The next thing that would be a deal breaker for me is if a bag is too heavy. And the one I have here, this is the Louis Vuitton Twist in the Epi leather in the MM size, which is the medium size. I also have the PM size, which is the smaller and is an awful lot lighter. This is quite heavy. When this has stuff in it, when you put your items in this, say your wallet, your phone, even just your essentials, because it does hold a decent bit, it's a good size, this becomes quite heavy. It's actually quite heavy on its own. I think this is probably close to the heaviest type of bag that I could go for. I would already, if I wear this for too long and have everything in it, I would struggle with this on my shoulder. It would start to hurt a little bit. This would actually become heavier and more uncomfortable than the Chanel 19, which has all of the chain detail. This, the leather of this on its own is heavier, and that would be something for me. I know that it's, I don't have a jumbo, but it's something I would certainly be bearing in mind if I was going to look at a jumbo as to the size and the weight of it. The next deal breaker for me is structure. I don't like bags that are too overly structured. I have the Louis Vuitton Brea in the PM, which is the small size. I used to have it in the MM, which was the bigger size, and it was too big and too structured for me, and I sold it. I think I used it once and sold it in perfect condition with the everything still attached to it. I like to wear bags crossbody. I like to be hands-free. I like to at least have the option to be hands-free. And if they're too structured and sit out too much to your side, I don't really enjoy that. So this, the Brea, is probably one of my most structured bags, that along with the Chanel Boy, which can also sit out quite bulky. When you wear it across body, it can sit quite rectangular. It can just sit a little bit rectangular whenever you're wearing it cross body. And it's probably one of my least worn Chanel bags, and that would be part of the reason, just because of the structure of it. I do like the Givenchy Antigona, but that is the reason I wouldn't buy it. And that takes me into my next deal breaker, which is they have to at least have the possibility of a strap to be worn crossbody. If a bag is just a handheld bag, I won't use it. I won't get enough use out of it. This bag I didn't really wear until I tried. It has its own crossbody strap, but until I tried the Pochette Matisse strap with it, which is more comfortable and more wearable, and then I was able to get a bit more wear out of this. So if a bag doesn't have crossbody option, doesn't have a strap, don't buy it, because the chances of wearing it are really quite slim. And that then takes me to my last handbag deal breaker. I actually had more of these than I thought when I started to think about it, and that is the size of the bag. This is the YSL Lulu in the small size, and when I looked at getting this, I also looked at the medium size, thinking that most of my bags are small. I have a lot of mini bags, and it would be add something a bit bigger, be able to carry a bit more. But when I looked at it and thought about my lifestyle, the reality is I just wouldn't use it. I don't use bags that are overly big. On a daily basis, I don't carry that much. I have downsized wallets. I don't carry a huge amount of SLGs with me. The only exception to that is the Louis Vuitton Neverfull. And I use the GM religiously for work. It is my workhorse. But because it goes to work, it carries my laptop, it carries my files, it carries my notebook, it carries my agenda, carries pens, pencils, all of that stuff. So it works for me being really big because it is for that purpose. But for a normal everyday bag, if it is too big, it won't work for me. And that is probably the biggest that I go for, is the YSL in the small size, or again, probably even the LV Brea, and that's in the small size. I sold the bigger one because bigger bags just don't work for me. So that's it. That would probably be, yeah, I can't think of any more. That would be my 6 deal breakers for handbags and the things that would rule me out. And just put me off. I can see in the background, you see the Chanel bucket bag in the background. That's the small size again. And before, when I was looking for that, I did find the medium size on the resale market, but I didn't buy it because it was too big. So that's definitely one for me, is the size of the bag. So that's it. I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope you're well. I think most people have done this. If you haven't, I am going to tag a few people that I will leave in the description box down below. If you're tagged, please do it. It's good fun. It's interesting to see what puts other people off bags. Sorry again for the noise. I hope you're well. Thank you so much for joining me. If you've enjoyed this, please give it a thumbs up. Take care, be safe, and I'll see you in the next one.